It's getting it all clean.
And then
very physical work. And then we'll move on to your washboards. There's a nice one, a glass one with a soap on the top.
And this would be the pantry.
Yeah. And you keep your coal, your peat in here. And even there for your, you could have a goose inside the house where your nest.
Laying the eggs there.
Boil your kettle or cook your bare bannocks or whatever it is you're making that day. And we'll get.
Oh, it, now that smell is just.
Is it now lovely?
It's a lovely smell.
It's a nice smell.
Yeah. And here, anybody have an idea what this might be?
Ooh, let's see. Oh, that. Mm-hmm. Which one? This
machine here.
All right, let's see. Ooh, mom's recording. Let's see.
What do you think, Thomas?
I have a real mouse trap.
Watch your finger.
It's a mouse trap.
Yeah, it's a moose trap.
Yeah, it looks.
You become little moose.
You can see the little.
Oh, careful.
And then the thing falls.
So there'll be threshing here in this part of the floor.
Oh.
Sorry, I have no grain to thresh, but you can see the roughness of the floor here where they would have done that. So you'd probably had two people doing that, and then you'd be doing it, turn one person, then keeping it going. And then I'm sure you've heard about a threshold. And this here is a good example of why your door, entrance to your door is called a threshold. Because once you did that, you open both doors, and it lets the wind blow through. And the loose chaff grain that you don't want blows out through the door, and the heavier grain that you want to keep gathers here at the door. So that's why it's called a threshold. It holds your thresh. In the doorway here, throw a rope, just hook it in there like that, pull it down, and then begin to turn. If somebody wants to take over the turning,
come on, Thomas.
You can do the turning part and all it. Keep going. And it's not the tidiest rope. But it's actually quite strong if you want to get that off.
Ooh, take a war.
Yeah, so that's how you make a straw rope.